This video will walk you through how to make and use a circular list in C++. So what is a circular list? A circular list is a linked list where the last element does not end with no, and there is no first element. Instead, the last element points to the first element, and there's one link current which can move around and be equal to any one of these links. So it might seem confusing. Now let's see how we're going to organize this. So the first thing is, let's examine what we have and try to visualize it. So we have a class link which has a integer data, and it has a link next which is equal to no initially when we make a new link. In addition to this, we have a class called circlist which has numlinks, and it also has a field for a link called current which initially is also going to be equal to zero, and we're going to set the numlinks equal to zero. So current is equal to no, and then our numlinks is equal to zero as soon as we make a new list using the constructor. So let's examine some of the things that we're going to do here. So first we're going to say circlist circ. Now what this is going to do is it's going to call my constructor, and using the constructor we're going to make this object named circ, which is going to have numlinks zero and current is equal to null. As soon as we do that, then the next thing to do is I'm gonna test some things, which is to check to see if the list is empty. How do I know if the list is empty? Well, I have a method which returns true if the number of links are equal to zero, which is when it's empty. In addition to this, I also have a display list. How does this display list work? Well, it has, first it checks to see if the list is not empty, and then it starts a counter I at zero, and then makes a loop that goes on until I is less than number of links. And so the number of links is how many links we have added, which is a number we're going to increase every time we add a new link. So then with this loop we can go through all the links and show every individual link. So that's our display. And if the list is empty, then we're going to show that it is empty. So that is my display. So initially when I test it, it tells me that the list is empty, which is what I want to see. Okay. Now the next thing I'm going to do is let's insert some values. So the first one, actually let's try to find a value. So we're trying to find a value of 10, and let's see how we're going to find a value. The way the find a value works is similar to how we displayed the list. We check to see if it's empty, then we make a loop that goes through all the links, and we're checking to see if the current data is equal to the value we're looking at. So basically what this method will do is it will stop the current at the link with the value that we're looking at. So that's the purpose of the found. And if it finds a link with a value we're looking, it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. So that's the found method. Now, the next thing we're going to do is, so we're testing to find 10, and we're seeing that it's false. So this method works. Now, the next one is inserting the initial link. So how does the insert initial link work? Well, the insert initial link, first we check to see if it's empty, which is we need the list to be empty in order for us to insert the initial link. And then what we're going to do is we're going to make a new link. So let's say we're inserting the value 10, right? So we're inserting the initial link with a value of 10, right? So the first thing we're going to do is we'll make a new link, right, which is going to be given a value of 10. Then the next thing we're going to say is that current is equal to new link. So line 47, current equals new link. So current is equal to the new link, and the new link we're naming it L1. So let's just say this is L1. So basically I have told the current that you're equal to this particular link, L1. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm saying current next is equal to the new link. Current next, current is L1. Current next is this field. So current next is equal to new link. So I'm basically telling it this one here is equal to L1. So I'm literally telling this link, link to yourself. And then the next thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to say numlinks plus plus. And now my number of links increases to 1. So that's the effect of inserting the initial link. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to test to see how insert after value found works. So how does the insert value found works? Well, it takes a value to insert and a value to find. And we're going to insert this value if we find this one, and we're going to insert it after this link, the one that has this value. So let's say in this case, we're trying to insert 20 after 10, right? So we're trying to insert 20. This is 20, and we're trying to insert it after 10. So first of all, how does this work? Well, we're going to call the found function, or a found method, and then we're going to go up here. So let's see how this is going to work. So current initially is equal to L1, right? And my list is not empty. So we're going to go in there and we're going to say, is current data equal to the value? So what's the value that we're looking at? The value we're looking at is, we're looking for the value 10, right? So the value to find, the value to find is 10. So we're looking for 10. And if my current data is equal to that 10, so my current is L1, right? And if the current data, if L1's data is equal to 10, which it is, we're going to return true. And basically, current is still at L1. We haven't moved it. So we're going to return true. We're going to come back here. And now we're going to make a new link with a value to insert. So that new link is 20. I'm going to name it 2. So new link with a data of 20. We're making it here. We're going to tell that its field initially is equal to null, just like we make all these new links. Then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to say new link next is equal to the current next. New link next is this right here. And I'm telling it is equal to the current next. Current next is this field. So I'm telling this equals this, right? Current next is now equal to L1, right? Current next. New link next is equal to the current next. That's what we did. New link next is equal to the current next. So I have basically linked these two links together like so. Now the next thing that we're doing is we're going to say current next is equal to new link. So current next is this, is equal to the new link, which is L2. So we're basically telling this here, you're equal to L2. And now I have basically created a link like so between the two links, right? So each link links with the other one. Now let's go and see how we're going to insert another link. So this was where we inserted 20 after 10. And then if we display the list, it's just going to show itself like so, right? Now the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to insert 30 after 20. Let's see how that works. So we're going to insert 30 after 20. So we're inserting 30 after 20. So the value that we're going to look for is going to be 20. Okay. My current hasn't moved yet, right? So we didn't move the current itself. We only moved current next. right? So current is still at L1. Now let's see how found works. So we're looking for 20, we're starting at 10, and my current, we're gonna move through the two links now that I have, right? So as soon as I added the new link, I increased this by plus one. As soon as I inserted the new link, we increased the numlinks to two. So now we're looking at a loop that's gonna happen two times. Current is gonna move through all the links. So initially current is equal to L1, and we're looking, is the data of this equal to 20? No. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna tell it, okay, well then the current goes to the current next. So current is equal to the current next, so current is gonna be L2, okay? So now that the current is L2, we're gonna check again. Is current data equal to the value? Well, the current now is L2, and the current data is 20, which is equal to the value we're looking for. So now current basically has stopped at this link. So this is my current link. And what we're gonna do is, now we're gonna return true to the insert after value found. So this is returning true. And we're gonna make a new link with a value of 30. So that's my new link here. We're gonna make its field initially equal to null. So next of this is equal to null. Now the next thing here we're gonna do is we're gonna say new link next is equal to the current next. So what is new link next? New link next is this field right here. And I'm telling it this here is equal to my current next. My current next, my current is L2, and my current next is L1. So I'm telling this here is equal to L1. Okay? So basically now, what I have done is I have established a link between this and this link, right? So link 3 links to L1. Now the next one here is current next is equal to new link. So current next, current is L2, current next is this, is equal to the new link. So now this here, instead of being L1, now changes to L3, which is what my new link is. So in other words, this arrow now is going to point to this here. Okay, and you can see that we have already created a circular list using this mechanism. Okay, and then if I wanted to, I can display this, right? So if I wanted to display this list after I inserted the 30 after 20, right? We're gonna display list, and let's jump to the display list and see how that works. So display list, again, checks to see if it's not empty, which it isn't, makes a loop that's going to happen three times for these links, and then it just shows me every link. So current is initially to L2, so the first thing we're going to see is going to be the 20, right? And then what it's going to do is it's going to say current is equal to current next, so current is equal to this is equal to the current next, which is the L3. So now it's going to go to this one, and we're going to show the 30, right? That's the order in which these are shown here. Okay, we're showing the 20, the 30, and then the next thing is, again, current is equal to the current next. For the last time, it's going to move to this one now, which is the last link it's going to show me, and it's going to be the 10. So it's going to show 20, 30, 10, and that is what you're seeing here. Okay, so this is basically, in a nutshell, how we insert links into a circular list and how we display the circular list.